Hello. Good morning. Good day. Good evening. Welcome to the stream. Jumping right into it. Do got some tunes today. Just in kind of a mood. Hey, Gonzo. Welcome. I hope you can hear me okay. Soundcheck is the next item on the agenda, as is tradition. Awesome. I might just get the hang of this someday. Okay. Yeah, so the first thing I wanted to do today... Let me just turn the tunes down just a little bit. The first thing I wanted to do today is we implemented over the past couple of weeks the feature that says a patch can have a folder path under the cities category. So things make sense, right, with like patches that come with beautiful cities of Morrowind. So I wanted to go through and kind of like, you know, get some of those updated as part of this whole, you know, 0.4 effort that we're doing. So let's jump into that. Cool. All right. Thank you, Gonzo. So I think we're going to find quite a few of them in here. Let's see. Thank you, LSP, for spamming me. One of these days, I'm going to figure out what knob I need to... I know I did it once. Stop it from spamming me about things like that. Just auto-know about that folder. Anyways, so let's do this. Beautiful cities. Okay, so... oh my. Let's... And patches. Okay, thins it out a little bit. Okay. Down from 70, because there are probably many mentions. Each patch mentions beautiful cities of Morrowind itself in the description. So we narrow it down to the patch's title itself, and we got 25, actually, which, woo. I expected a lot, but okay, well, without further ado, here we go. This should be pretty easy and quick. The most time-consuming thing would be, you know, adding a change log, which I feel like we should do. As much as I really dread the idea, I feel like it's simple copy-paste, you know, working alongside here and here. So yeah, let's do it. Let's quit talking and do it. Okay, what's today? 4, yes. Alright, and we're gonna do a custom folder. Yeah, just like that. Just like this one, except it's gonna be... Let's actually pull up the website here. It's actually going to be this. And I love copy-pasting to prevent making a stupid mistake. Okay. So I'm not going to check every single one, but we're going to check this first one after I put a changelog in, just to get into the groove of, all right, you know, I can reasonably copy-paste a good work and simplify the rest. Right, and whoops, don't try this at home. Oh my, what was I doing now? I need this, okay, we need to go back actually to here, and we're looking at, what is this? Patch for purist patch. Just so I'm sure who gets what. Graphics overhaul. Not using patch for purist. Give me the game as Todd intended. With some exceptions. Okay. And just let's take a gander at this diff here. Two new fields. Some might have been updated before, and it will be an update on that field. and a quick blah into the change log. So without further ado, excuse me. And let's do that. I'm going to take a sip of my breakfast. Okay. Excuse me. And we'll get ready to load this up. I think it's pretty safe to say that all of these are going to be expanded vanilla, total overhaul, and I think this is something that I can just copy-paste into every entry, and we can, you know, we can fact-check that after the fact, so I don't spend a lot of time, because, while it's crunching, huh? One, two. Tabs overload here. All right. Should I keep going? Let's keep going. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So, yeah, some of these, it does make sense. Some of these, you know, Foyata Mamea ink definitely included there. Some of them not used in any at the moment. This would certainly be re-added at some point, and if you feel like using Province Cyrodiil fits in fine, great, you know, great mod. Just in the interest of minimizing the change footprint on the current release, it's not getting added in at the moment. Yeah, friendly reminder about that Anvil content. If you didn't check that out yet, Gonzo. So yeah, just a quick scan. Seems like probably half and half with a couple stragglers, right? TR Travels. This is should actually have a note that it, yeah, no longer provided. Okay, it does. Gonna go ahead and close that. No longer provided. Gonna close that. Okay, so I think that was a worthy thing to check. Okay, are we there yet? Yeah, we're there yet. Okay. Cool. Boom, there it is. Tets today, for me at least. Okay. Okay. Very nice. Let's... 8 patches. Nice. Okay, very good. Very good. Thank you for that, Gonzo. Says I'm counting 8 patches that have a different configuration than just TO and EV. So that's good. Thank you for that. Super handy. Okay, where's the list change log? Boom, right there. It's, you know, just a small little bit of extra code to give people a nod. Like, hey, but wait, shouldn't just say updated. That's actually a very terrible note, I think. So let's get this going on here. The auto formatter fighting me once again. Updated to advise a more logical folder path. I think that's all I really need to say. It's the truth. I don't think it's necessary to get into the details that it was wrong and what is right. You know, that's not really important. I don't think. All right, well. Okay, so aside from, you know, the paltry changelog there, which I've already augmented, as we can see right here, is updated to advise a more logical folder path. And I think that's just what's going to be blah for all of them. Because, yeah, that's a really all that's going on. That's all we're changing here. And so, I'm going to do this one on its own, and then I'm just going to do chunks. Awesome. Okay. Custom. Boom. There we are. Okay. And so, yeah, from here out, I'm hoping it's going to be just a quick, you know, we'll get through these pretty quick. Just some copy pasta. What are we? Oh, you know what? That's no good, though. Nice. Very good. Oh, and this reminds me, too, I still have to go back to yesterday's stream and get our discussion about the button layouts and stuff. We still got to do that and put those in issues on GitLab. Because we had some good ideas there, and we don't want that to get lost. So that helps Gonzo big time, just in the chat there, which I have yet to, like, include as part of the video yet, but I probably will do. Listed the ones that are different from just the you know, the ones that deviate. So that's super handy. I'll try to remember to peek over there as I'm working. Please chime in if I screw it up. All right. Moving on. Oh, yeah, I fudged the time. Different from the copy pasta, says Gonzo, yes. 11:11. What a lovely time. I think the extent of the changes we need here. Let's get at least ready to do more work there. What's up? Free Adam Amaya. I think this is one of the ones, yeah. Plus graphics overhaul. Thank you kindly, Gonzo. Yeah. Very good. All right. And yeah, so I'm just going to start, you know, I got one little commit that it kind of has a decent message, and then I'm just going to start bundling these, and, you know, maybe we'll do, like, a handful and check it out, or maybe we'll just fuck, you know, we'll just plow through it. But this was, but I had a, while I was working on the Ghostgate plugin, just thought of this, and it bugged me. We got to fix these paths. We added the feature. We got to use it now because it's just sitting there. So, all right. And concept arts plus graphics overhaul. So that's a boom copy paste right there. Good. Good, good. One of these days, I'm going to find a new, I'm sure somebody has, like, some kind of a slick thing. This is Emacs talk now for, because I'm, like, moving over here, but I want to move up here, and every time I have to move up, there's got to be a way. Someday I'll figure it out. Back to reality. Okay, Siege at Firemoth. I don't think that one's graphics overhaul. Arguably, that's vanilla content. I don't know. That's up for debate. All right, so we got three. That kind of matches my diff over here. A little sanity check. Yeah, I'm not even going to bother with this one. Or this one. Puts me in the unfortunate position of needing a fresh copy paste. Not in mod lists, doesn't need to go on a change log. Gonna get this updated nonetheless. Now that it's sort of out in the open in yesterday's video, or at least available, and we need to create a link. How to customize, though, the mod list from the CFG generator. Somebody could reasonably easily add this into Total Overhaul. So we want that to be a good folder path. NPC schedules. Ooh, I can't wait to do this one with Lua. Because with Lua, we could say like, okay, we can make generalizations based on class. We can support mods more easily and conflict-free, you know. Just giving a shout-out to, by the way, what is it? Help me out here, Gonzo, with that one mod that was disabling the negative lights with Lua. That's the, my friends, the future of fixing things in a magically compatible way that is, you know, free of some of the rituals we have to do now. Okay, I already did that. Oops, just have to save. Kind of got excited thinking about disabling negative lights with Lua. Remove negative lights. I, for some reason, don't have a... Let's just use the old search engine. This is the future right here. And what's so cool about it, if I may go on a tangent, and let's open up the source code. Remember where I even put this. Lighting, of course. This is why I hate category naming, because I never even understand my own rationale. All right, but yeah, just, you know, for the sake of argument, you know, we're looking at this. I put that in there. But this is the mod that you get from Nexus Mods. And it's just, I put that in there too. That's it, you know. Like, it doesn't care what plugin adds it. I don't even think it matters where you put the OMW scripts in your load order, because it's going to get called by the engine at the same time anyway. There's like a certain point in the startup where Lua scripts start loading. Yeah, chef's kiss, 16 lines. I mean, this is, and you know, they're even generous with white space to make it a little more readable, you know. This kind of stuff is why I like Lua, because right here, putting this all in one line, it really makes sense. You know, it's like you're reading a sentence in English almost, you know. You could arguably put all this on one line. You don't need to, you know. And yeah, it comes out to just a tiny little package here, hooking into on object active, which again happens at a certain point when the engine, if you look at the documentation on Read the Docs, when the engine, you know, puts something into existence, basically. So yeah, it's awesome. I'm super thrilled by this, but it's 0.49 only feature. So really can't put that to work yet, but oh boy, when we can, that's the future. You'll remember, actually, Gonzo, also, I'm glad you're here too, because I wanted to say, we have the, you pointed out last night about the dupe wheel in the patch for Imperial. I'll get to your, Gonzo says, is there anything else in point 49 I'm looking forward to? We'll get to that in a moment. The dupe wheel, though, you pointed out. And actually, I wanted to just call out what that change looks like. I'm actually not, now that I've spent the past week or so, you know, really leveling up my understanding of the quirks and implementation details of the engine, And just look at the change here to the plugin in text format. We have a different size for BCOM. Went down a little bit, looks like. And all that's changed is the ref number here. And this sort of kind of exposes the detail to you of, okay, well, so what we're looking at here is this number, and this is a caveman understanding of the engine still, but what we could be looking at here is just kind of the number of things that are in the plugin, right, which will change from time to time as RandomPal updates the mod, which thankfully is, you know, frequently. Does RandomPal mean for the wheel to be broken and leaning up against the wall? Do you mean like how it's like going into the wall, sort of, and my patch fixes that, Gonzo? Excuse me. No, and I'll show you why. We know that. Let's start up a new game again. Apologies about potato quality. I'm just slacking on moving my gaming PC over here. I put it back on my TV. But I'll show you how it looks without Imperial Town's revamp. And it looks fine, to jump ahead. It looks fine. And the patch, obviously, is not needed in vanilla. But this is vanilla without any patching by me or anything. Looks fine, right? That's how it's supposed to be. And so Imperial Town's revamp has the meshes. Yeah, like this mesh here, you can see it. It's just like a flat thing, and you can have Met upscale the texture, or Intelligent Textures, or any other upscale project will upscale the texture. You can use normal maps to kind of give the illusion of more detail, but at the end of the day, the mesh is just like a flat curve, whereas with Imperial Town's revamp, it's like, I mean, get up close to it in the game, you know, it looks like a real stone. It's exquisite detail. So the consequence of that, though, is, you know, any kind of thing, it's, you know, real bumpy indeed. Gonzo says it's real bumpy. The consequence, though, of that, and actually, I started while I was working on the BCOM distant buildings compatibility patch. I also remembered seeing, and maybe we can take a look today, in Tribunal, in some of the sewer areas, the Caves revamped meshes didn't like connect right to some of the vanilla Tribunal things that it doesn't implement. And so that would be, for me personally, a spicy one to fix because I've got zero modeling skills. So I don't know. We can look, but definitely, you know, look at that later. Because that is something that's like, you're playing. No, and it's not. So it's not Mines and Caverns. And I did on Discord, I mentioned when we were talking about that, I said I didn't remember why I removed that from mod lists. And I think I did remember. And it was related to kind of a mindset I had last year where, like, when I was adding in Beautiful Cities of Morrowind for the first time to the mod lists, I was having, like, this cut everything out and simplify, like, kind of a knee-jerk reaction to the realization of how much stuff BCOM does and how well it does it, you know, and how much I was doing and how poorly I was doing it. And as I was like, yeah, just cut all the things out, you know. And so I cut Mines and Caverns out. There was Beautiful or Better Caves and Caverns by Pikachu, which was coming up and looking very promising, and I thought, you know, we'll jump to that one eventually. And I don't know, looking at Mines and Caverns now, it's thoughtfully updated, thoughtfully implemented, and it's really great. Maybe there will be further problems from throwing that in the mix. Yeah, I don't know. I guess we'll find out. 24, and I didn't actually put a change log in. Just kind of yakking. And we'll see where these fall with regard to, let's see here. Wall art plus graphics overhaul. Okay, that would be the first one. And Morrowind. Starwind into cheese. We have to, another user on Discord pointed out there is a patched version of this, which includes changes from some of the other balance mods that are on the list. I can't name them exactly right now, and I don't want to misname them. But one of the things I definitely want to do is take a careful look at what those changes are and can they be implemented into RandomPal's anti-cheese patch, you know, as a, yet another patch maybe. Because it's definitely a good one. And the ones it touches are no doubt good, you know. We want to make sure that we do it right for all the things that we have. All right. On that note, let's bring this one in. Starting to look like a pretty big change set. All right, well, nonetheless, keep going. Glass glow set. Okay, so this one, not necessarily going to be a copy-paste here. And you know what? Since Gonzo was nice enough to kind of jump ahead and throw in the chat which ones are... I think it's safe that we can just close these tabs because it's driving me nuts and I can't keep track of what's open. Let's actually pull one tab open, though, here. We want glass, glow, set. Okay. Double checked it. Nice. Thank you so much. Excellent. That's so great. Very, very, very helpful. Okay. But this is going to come from OAAB data. Yeah. Okay, so we want to know what is the path for OAAB data, which I've, if I may take a moment here and just call out this project as probably one of the most important projects in Morrowind modding, you know, since Tamriel rebuilt. Just the amount of amazing stuff pumped out by these people blows my mind away. Props. We're going to go like this because that's where it's going to live in reality. Yep. Okay. Yeah, this is a nonsense path. Nobody's gonna really have that. Okay. I think that's gonna do it for that one. Bringing that over. I need a updated time. Hey, Santa Hools, one of my real life friends. Welcome, buddy. Thanks for joining. Santa, I have known for a long time, has not played Morrowind. I don't know what his deal is, but maybe someday we'll get there and I can consider him a true friend. Maybe someday. Yeah, I know, right? Shake, head shake, everybody. We'll get there. He's, you know, we'll get there. He can be taught, I think. Okay. Whoop. You know what? I'm going to go up here and so I don't make a stupid copy pasta error. It is 29 after. Okay. Boom, boom. Moving on. Proteus. Wait, like the walking simulator? He says, I've been playing Proteus all morning. The walking simulator one that's like a trippy visuals. That one? Oh, boomer shooter. Oh, I see. Okay. Sounds fun. Weapon sheathing patch is another, the next one that we need here. Oops. There we go. And for this one. Oh. I didn't put a link there. Speaking of boomer shooter, I should just want to... One of my pie-in-the-sky OpenMW Lua mod ideas, I have many, in addition to my lawn mowing simulator that someday we will have, Todd willing, I want to have like a Quake Arena mini game. Once we're able to control combat more, I want to have like a Dwemer combat arena that's like, yeah, Quake Arena, you know. Oh, I think that would be pretty fun. Those kinds of games are simple, but stand the test of time. Yeah, it would be awesome. Well, you know, so in theory, like as the Lua API grows, parts of the engine are de-hard-coded and we get access to that stuff. It's re-implemented in Lua and we get access to it. Oh, the bonk mod? Yeah, Gonzo says, I really wish that bonk mod was compatible with OpenMW. It is a MWSC Lua mod where you can like do non-lethal takedowns by bonking people in the head, more or less. Probably does a lot more than that, but that's a nutshell. And I mean, you know, so when I look at that and I think, what's required to do that with OpenMW? Give me Thief or Give Me Death. Nice. Yeah, those are actually on my to-do list. I, of course, got copies on the good old games. But yeah, I mean, when I think of like, what do we need to have in the engine to do that? We would need to be able to like control what happens when you hit somebody, basically, and where you hit them. And we just don't have that in the engine right now. To the degree I think it's needed. You know, we don't have a combat API, but that certainly didn't stop, for example, Sotha from implementing the combat pack, which, well, you know, I've been playing with it more and more, and it's like really adds a cool flair to combat that it just, you know, makes a big difference to the kind of like, you know, old school feeling Morrowind combat you get out of the box. And in a nutshell, what I'm talking about is the Sotha's combat pack if you haven't tried it, gives you, you know, really short buffs and debuffs based on different actions you're doing. And yeah, it spices up the combat to where like I used to crank up difficulty a little bit just because it was too easy. Now I don't need to do that. You know, that combined with other nerfing and other such plugins. Good stuff, you know. Back to this. I'm kind of on autopilot here. And I also found that works pretty good with Starwind so far. Started a Starwind character yesterday on my Steam Deck. It's a good fit. Gonzo says, not quite seeing issues with the Mournhold sewers. That's fantastic. One of the things I used to do that seems like a good idea, but obviously in hindsight I don't have a record of any of it, is when I'm playing the game, if I see something janky, I would be like, oh, look at that, and save the game looking at the thing or whatever, and give the saved game name a description of a vague description of what it is, you know, like Saved Rift Mora, blah, you know, something. And then, you know, as a consequence, I would end up with like a bunch of old saves that, you know, roughly document the issues I found. But then it's just like, you know, where even are those anymore, you know? So the approach that we're taking now with trying to like fly around and notice things is really good. It's hard to find everything that way, obviously. So all right, we're gonna go back or do a new search, I guess. But if you don't find anything down there, you know, first off, thanks for hopping in there and taking a check. If you don't find anything, that's great. I have a distinct memory of weird. If you're using the Mournhold mod by RandomPal, though, maybe, you know, that's been updated, or maybe there was something there, or I don't know. I did a bad job of documenting that one. Oop.
Where am I? Here we go.
Bits not lining up. Okay, there you go. Yeah, so Gonzo says, oh, wait, I'm seeing bits not lining up now. Yeah, so that is, you know, in theory, and correct me if I'm wrong, but so what you're seeing is kind of a vanilla e-mesh coming up against a Caverns revamp mesh, and it's just like, you know, so like, what's the solution? Implement some kind of a Caverns revamp D-mesh for Tribunal? Does one simply do that? I mean, you know, it takes expertise to do that. I can't do that, you know. So, like, what's the approach to fix that? I don't know. And correct me if I'm wrong, but it looks hideous, right? So, I don't know what we do about that kind of a thing. And speaking of, I don't know what we do about that kind of a thing, but I do know what to do about this one. And maybe we'll do it in a future stream. Is Welcome to the Arena, known to be quite broken with OpenMW for various reasons. I think it's nothing we can't fix, honestly. A couple script adjustments, you know, and we can do a patch on top of the patch, basically, kind of a thing here. I'm confident we could do it, and I'm confident it wouldn't be that hard. So, scrolling back up here. Okay, this one's just going to be these two, I think, because this is definitely a gameplay kind of a thing. I tried a little bit to keep, you know, gameplay, such gameplay things out of graphics overhaul. Okay, yeah, Gonza says, when you get some time, I'd like to see what you see, because it took me a while, but I just found a misaligned seam. Obviously not stream time worthy. Yeah, for sure. We can talk about it off stream. Let me know the cell. If you want to, like, message me on Discord, just let me know the cell name there that you're in and kind of, you know, maybe a pick of the map. But I bet you found what I found or something kind of like it, you know. So anyway, yeah, and also we should carve out some time, perhaps next week, just like spawn in a cheater character and you know, that's uber powerful, and do Welcome to the Arena and see what's broken, you know, and fix them. I'm pretty handy with MW script at this point. We could do it for sure. Okay, enough yammering. All right, this is one we're going to need to search for. Oop. This isn't where I want to be. This is where I want to be. No. Yeah. This one. All right, this one definitely going to be on mod lists. Two outstanding mods that blow my mind away. Uncharted Artifacts actually is one that kind of inspired me to do the NWAS guide. And I didn't quite go as far as this mod goes. Like, it will, you know, show you a pop-up when you get by a treasure. I didn't quite go as far as that one. But indeed, in the future, I want to expand it, you know, to have like a checklist, and do want to add mention of a few other things, in particular some of the stuff that we will be adding, like the newer content that came out from this year's Modathon. 39. Okay, wow. So I think let's just take a step back here for a moment. We got quite a few changes queued up here. You know, but I think we're just going to power on and do them all in one big chunk here. Not that bad, I don't think. Take a quick breather here. All right, moving on. In a perfect world, I would be able to somehow like reference BCOM itself here rather than having this hard coded. If I'm talking about like how I can improve my crappy code. There would be some way to just say like beautiful cities of Morrowind here. And it would like extrapolate this from that. I would consider that like a, if you're somebody wanting to contribute to the project and you know a little bit of Python, maybe a little bit of Django, and you want to fix something up, I would definitely accept that as like a little improvement feature. Which made me say, I was thinking internally with some tests, but then I thought, you know, well, the tests as they stand now are kind of woefully pathetic, so really it's on me to fix those up before I expect others to do so. But I would appreciate some tests to go along with such a feature. And maybe tests are something that would be interesting to do on the stream. Maybe not. It's strictly a coding thing, you know? Like, here we got a little coding mixed awkwardly with Morrowind stuff. This one not going to be scrolling back up here. If I recall, not going to be graphics overhaul, yeah. Good, good. This one, too, also not going to be graphics overhaul. And someday I want to take a stream to, already got this there. Take a stream and just dedicate it to, you know, looking at graphics overhaul specifically. And making sure that it's not like a little extra bloated. You know, maybe there's some quest stuff thrown in there that's maybe a little distasteful for people not looking for that. I'd like to do that. Moving on. I updated this one quite recently. Anyway, that's why is irrelevant. Just kind of thinking to myself, why did I do that? I don't know. As I said before, no graphics overhaul here. Excuse me. All right. So according to my little thing down here, we are 74% through the file. Not everything is going to need, you know, that remains is going to need this touch, but probably a lot of them will. Just scrolling ahead. Right, like this one, going to need it, yeah. Probably quite a few. Excuse me. Yeah, okay. Another one that wouldn't be in the graphics list. A worthy addition, in my opinion. Nonetheless, not in there by default. Not this one. Yes, this one. And this would be one that is noted to be in graphics overhaul as well. Oh. I'm like, where's my changes? There they are. Okay. I think also one, right? Yeah, if it's not on there, it should be. Yeah, okay. Oops, yikes, what did I do? Kind of the reverse situation here. Not a vanilla thing. What's going on, computer? My laptop's chugging a little bit. Just OBS doing its thing. Not really much I can do about that. This one I would think. Be on all three. Yeah. Yep. I was dreading doing this from the moment we implemented this a few weeks ago, but it's like, this is a rip the band-aid off kind of a thing. We got to do it. We're doing it. Boring as it may be. I think this one might be in all of them too. Gonzo, good question. Asks, essentially, this is just putting those BCOM patches inside the city's town's BCOM folder, right? That's exactly right. And if you look here, if we look at, for example, this one, and we can see the path I'm telling people is to do this. And this is just... Nobody would do that. It doesn't come there. It comes with Beautiful Cities of Morrowind. So, you know, when you extract it, when you take it out of there with whatever, that's where it's going to be. It's not going to, like, you'd have to move it yourself, and it's just, yeah. Yep. Yep. Gonzo, yeah, I did something different myself. Yeah, so it just, it doesn't. So this is what we're fixing now, and I think it's an important fix towards making the CFG generator be more usable, you know, as something that you can just copy pasta and it's going to work for you. Another future feature that I would really, 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 really love to do is basically letting you put your own in there and having the CFG generator use that. Would be a little bit of JavaScript. Not a lot, I don't think. We wouldn't need to adopt a framework like I was showing the other day. I wouldn't think. Yeah, so this is all three. I love pomegranates. And I thought when I first saw this, I'm like, adding pomegranates into Morrowind? Huh? But it is actually in, you know, correct me if I'm mistaken, but I believe it is actually in the lore. And if not, like, hey, they're beautiful. I'm going to sip my cherry juice. Are the pomegranates in the graphics list? Could argue successfully, yeah, that it's a gameplay thing. All right. Excuse me. Moving on. Good. Did that. Let's jump the gun a little bit then. Two pomegranates. Okay, yeah. That's not jumping the gun. This is where we want to be. Okay. I really need to. I just had a thought too. Another cool back end feature would be so we have like, I could just put this. This is the slug. Right here. And in, from a data perspective, it's unique for every mod. And I just had a thought, like, we could have some syntax where you put, like, the slug in curly braces or double curly braces like this. That would be the Django HTML templating syntax. And I could have, like, some template filter that would know. I would be like, you know, so that's like pseudocode, but yeah, it would be something like that. And then I wouldn't need like all this, you know, HTML boilerplate. I hate looking at that. Every time I look at that, I'm like, it's another place for me to make a mistake. Okay. All ranting aside. Improved ins expanded. Let's go back up here. Is that one that was noted? I'm guessing it's not. That would be gameplay. And yeah, Gonzo, double check that. Okay. It will be interesting to see the final diff in this file. We'll basically be able to divide it by two to get a rough idea of how many mods were touched. I'm guessing it's going to be a lot. Store entrance chimes. That one I'm going to say two, probably not. Graphics overhaul. Nope. Typos are killers. Yeah. Tell me about it. That's why, if I may, do I have it here? If I may, so digress. If we look at natural character growth and decay, that's why I've done seemingly silly things like, you know, assigned variables to basically everything that gets used more than once, but it's just like, now that I have this, for example, potion ID, I can go like this. And my editor, you can see right here, has it right there. And I can rely on my tooling to help me do the right thing. and not have to rely on my hands and my eyes. Because, yeah, I'm an old fogey. All right, back to it. Ends expanded. Got it on there. Boom. Getting a little tab crowded here. Is there a phobia for open tabs? There should be, Gonzo says. yeah, well, okay. I mean, there is some, so there is some background to this, I think, for me personally. My first few tech jobs in the industry were doing support at a hosting company. And so, like, we were, you know, responsible for a ticket queue. People would email in and we'd have a, you know, a ticket queue. And so, like, you know, we had to help people out and do it quickly and manage sometimes a lot. Like, sometimes there would be an insane amount. And, you know, so you'd have tons of tabs open for all the issues. And I think maybe that's where it comes from for me. It's like, I gotta close the tickets. Back to the mid-phase days. Meat face, catastrophic. You know what I'm, you know what I'm talking about, and a little bit of Wired Tree in there too. I worked with catastrophic at Wired Tree, another IRL friend. Glad to see you here, my friend. Yeah, we had a little bit of that there too. Just like, gotta, you know, hundreds, maybe thousands of servers, people all over the world having issues with their WordPress blogs, and that kind of a thing. Oh, wait. What am I doing? Soundtrack Sunday. All right. Zelda and Chilt. Nice. That would be Catastrophic stream. It's Catastrophic. You want to jump on over there and enjoy some very nice, very chill tunes. Oh, okay. Not today. Okay. Got to try the new one, Santa Hools. Yeah. Me too. I have a couple Switch games that I got queued up. Ah, Gonzo says, on forward, put out OK Computer in different Nintendo 64 sound fonts this morning. Wow, that sounds... OK Computer by Radiohead, I assume you mean. That sounds pretty interesting. Yeah, I want to hear that. Indeed. Wow, okay. I got super distracted by that just now, but that's a good... distraction. You got to link me to that. Drop it in the stream, Gonzo, please. Boom. Thank you. And one of these days, that stream will be in the video for you people in YouTube land. Sorry. Bounty Hunter Assignments, a good one, another one of many good ones by Alice. Excellent. Lots of fun side quests content. Yes. All right. Got to keep this going. Oh my gosh, we spent a good chunk of the stream doing this, but this is necessary. Todd's work right here. We're doing, folks. Oh my god. Meat face. Slowpoke there on that one. Oh my gosh, that brings me back. Oh, wait. Look. I can't believe it. We've reached the point in the file where I already started doing this. So we're done. Amazing. I've been just like on autopilot doing this that I didn't realize that we would get there eventually. And here we are. Wow. Okay. Make sure all files are saved. Good, 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 good. All right. Crunch it. The end of the tunnel came quick, right? Well, yeah, we had a kind of an interesting little side diversion there. To bury the lead, catastrophic, I was going to say Xenoblade Chronicles 1 and 2 have some of my favorite video game soundtracks. I mean, almost start to finish. And I can link you to specifics, but yeah, that's what I was going to... I immediately thought of that, but I'm like, I got to sit and think on it a little bit, but nah. Yeah, I'll send you a couple. Wow, I can't believe we actually did this. I thought, this is going to take the whole stream. Oh my goodness. This one, and let me know your thoughts, Gonzo. Re-add DDB for OpenMW. Two lists with the patch, with BCOM and the patch. Because I figure in the 5.x series, I had added the mod and also taken it away. So, I mean, it would kind of make sense to re-add it. I don't know. Or maybe that should wait. This one is a mistake, and I feel like should probably be added. I have it in my setup here. It's just one of the ones that got lost. This, as I mentioned, is something we could definitely do here. I could... what we'll do is we'll set up a minimal setup with just BCOM, Welcome to the Arena. We'll play through it. We'll break the game, and we'll fix it. We'll fix the scripts or whatever. Somebody mentioned this on Discord a while ago. They were not 100% clear on the Uvirith's Legacy Rise of House Tel'vanni patch that comes with Uvirith's Legacy. So just want to make sure my verbiage is clear on that. And let's take a look at what we got. Oof. Well, there you go, though. See, this is partly why I wanted to break out 5.4, breaking from 5.3. We'd be pushing 100 changes now, you know, and that's just like, you know. And I'm not going to double check all of these, but because we know even though I don't have tests, I think we know at this point the feature works. The custom folder feature works. But there you go. There you go. That's the change log. Let's take a look at... So this is expanded vanilla. Let's look at this one. It's just going to be a little bit more 24. Oh, okay. So there you go. And this one was, you know, added after the feature was introduced. Wow, cool. I mean, we did it. Wow. So another one of the things we have to do going forward, and I'm not going to do it on the stream because this is going to be more my kind of mind-numbing, in my opinion, stuff, but we have to look at, in GitLab, we've got quite a few issues here. There's 148 open issues, but, like, you know, like, this one will be fixed when we merge this merge request, but there's quite a few that are already fixed, you know, and I've not been very good about staying up to date on all these. With the status of them in terms of have I fixed them, with the labels, with all kinds of, you know. So, you know, Gonzo, if you're feeling adventurous and you want to go through, please go nuts. Feel free. Go nuts and identify, you know. And one of these days I will too. At some point. Todd willing. Okay. Well, so I'm satisfied with that. Change. It was a big one. Gonzo asks, should I flag them or just straight up close stuff? You know what? Flag them because I want to try and like correlate them to a specific commit and link to them before we close them. So if you just want to flag them, and maybe like if you want to add a tag, if you can't in GitLab add a tag, let me know and I'll try and either just add it or give you the permission to add them. But yeah, make a tag that says like needs closing or something like that. And that would be the best. Yeah, like the Ramirez mod graveyard stuff. Exactly, that kind of stuff. We can probably knock out 20 issues alone just by going through and closing things that need to be closed, you know. So, boom. You rock, man. All right. Let's commit this, you know. Implement the last change on hopefully. I knew it wasn't going to fit. Okay. I'm trying to, I mentioned this in a prior stream, but we got the line. They don't get, doesn't want you to have a line longer than a certain amount, and I'm not going to, you know, whatever. Everything else that needed. Good enough. All right. Wow. That is great that we got that done. I was really dreading that. All right. Excuse me. Oh, my. That was a hefty one. Ooh, you know, let's jump ahead to this one, because this will be a cool one to actually just show right now. I forget who linked to this one on Discord. Somebody on Discord linked to this one. Let's just go ahead and open it up and see what I'm talking about. A ground cover mod that seems to care about OpenMW and BCOM compatibility, which, hey, all right, nice. That's good for everybody. But notably, let's look at some of these pictures here. Very Aesthesia ground cover-esque. I like the flowers there. Okay, Gonzo says, I tried it. Maybe your mileage will be better, but it seemed to clash with some stuff in Sadanine. You know, I have a to-do item to actually fire up Ozzy's ground cover. Because BCOM supports it. Not all the things that patch BCOM, such as concept arts, plantations, fully supported as well, but I at least just want to see it because, yeah, I think Eddie swears by it. And it's a classic one. So, yeah, but this is right here. This could arguably go into the 5.x series, but this is the underwater ground cover, which, you know, normally you're naked under there. Let's have a look, huh? Okay. Slush synthesis. First, let's take a look without. Smalio, I still like the add-on with more trees, swampland. Ah, yeah, Smalio, also my lovely wife, my better half. She's talking about Ezzy's Forested Morrowind, which, if you're not familiar with it, let's pull it up. We're going to have to search for it. This is a bit of a... there we go. It's so pretty, yeah. This is a bit of a controversial one, but I love the liberties that he takes with it. But yeah, I mean, it puts just trees, you know, and there's a couple variants of it that have different degrees of trees that it adds, but it puts trees all over, you know, the map where they are not normally. And so it's obviously not for everybody taste-wise. Yeah, but yeah, and I mean, and I can definitely speak to how thoughtfully implemented it is, you know. He's actually built some really interesting tooling, as he is a programmer like me by profession, and he has some really interesting taste in textures too. You got the orange castle here and stuff. I just love seeing his screenshots because this is another mod of his too, this purple glow on the Telvanni towers. Yeah, vanilla, boom. One of these days we'll put it in on the stream. Oh yeah, and like this Vivek gives it like, I don't know, like a Mayan kind of, I don't even know what that color grouping is, but just bizarre but also cool. Need some classic textures from modding history. So yeah, anyway, that's Smalio. Thank you for mentioning. That's the one. But back to here. Let's go and grab that folder path. All right. Yeah, this was me last night working on that. So just want to quickly say we have the total overhaul patches that are going to find their way onto the website soon. Those of you hanging out in Discord already know about it, but it's basically just stuff that is going to fix things in soon-to-be-added content to the list, like this one for Redania Revised, if I'm remembering the name correctly. Fixes the placement of a mushroom, you know. This one we were talking about a little earlier fixes the wheel, and just other things, you know. So last night I was working on re-implementing the dynamic distant buildings and beautiful cities of Morrowind compatibility patch. And just to quickly explain what that is, beautiful cities of Morrowind changes Ghost Fence to look like this. Ghostgate Fortress by Resident Revival Team. Amazing mod that I used before, Beautiful Cities in Morrowind. It's fantastic. And Dynamic Distant Buildings would be by Himeris. And that gives you the effect of when a mod adds statics into the game that are maybe, you know, disappear or reappear at certain points in the story because it got built or it got torn down or whatever, you're going to see it basically in the distance regardless. And then when you get close, it'll pop out of view. And so, spoiler alert, if you haven't beaten Morrowind and you don't want to know about a spoiler, mute me for like a minute or skip ahead. But when you beat the game, these fences disappear. And unfortunately, they don't actually disappear until you get close out of the box. They will like sort of, they will look like they're there, and then when the cell actually loads into the active grid, they'll disappear. And so what the Dynamic Distant Buildings plugin does is it will go ahead and just disable them so that they're disabled and they're not going to pop out of existence. And Himeris put in support for Ghost Fence and the strongholds that ship with the vanilla game. And so what I've done is, yeah, I've just made it work with Beautiful Cities of Morrowind so that you don't hit, but out of the box, it would be like the vanilla Ghost Fence would be like right here. And it just was, it was pretty, it was brutal. So now we got that compatibility implemented in a great way. And thanks to everybody involved. People on Discord and most specifically RandomPal for kindly offering implementation advice. And I learned a lot about the Morrowind engine and the weirdness of deleting references. So yeah, going down a little rabbit hole for that was fun. And it ended up taking me a couple tries actually to get it quite right, but I digress. Let's do minimal performance tests. We're going to take a look at what the... Just making sure I'm keeping myself honest here. We're going to take a look at what things look like. Oh boy, there we go. Potato warning. Underwater. In the game. Here we go. Welcome to Morrowind Underwater, my friends. HWG. Santa. What? I'm not going to Google that right now, please. Speak old people language. Here we go, here we go. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Here we go. So look at this. This is 2001's best right here, my friends. As good as it's going to get. But wait. We found this mod. And it turns out it's actually... It's beautiful. I threw it into my... Let's... All right. This is not a lesson in... language. Boom! Here we go. Look at this. Not too bad. Get all that out of there. I'm a god mode. Of course, it doesn't get rid of the breath warning. Yeah, looks pretty good, though. And it's, you know, ground cover is a... If your computer is relatively modern, you know, it's not really that expensive of a feature. And so, you know, it behooves you to use this. And I'm just using, as you can see here, yeah, Gonzo. Yeah, that looks incredible. Indeed. Props to the author. Let's see who... we're dealing with here. Not me. Come on now. Let's give them proper Acid Zebra. Hey, awesome. I'm just using it for the underwater stuff, but hey, I mean, if you're not, if you maybe are not using everything, because I think if you do Total Overhaul list or Expanded Vanilla, you're going to have a couple things that might clash with this. Specifically, the River's ESP was... clashing with current ground cover, Gonzo says. Oh, I see. Interesting. Where at? Cell-wise, where about? And you mean with the Beautiful Cities of Morrowind ground cover? Because I want to see that. All right. Anywho. Let's, here we go. This is what I want to see. Okay, so the question is, excuse me, do we add this? I think we're going to with Ramirez. You can see it at, okay, immediately with both. Let's do that, shall we? All right. Here we go. HWG. Excuse me. Sedanine happens to be where I start out by default. Noted, you're using TR versions. Yeah, okay, so am I. Yep. Okay. What am I looking for? Oof, slideshow mode. Unfortunately, that is not an instant command, and we're going to have to wait a minute. That hill was... Okay, Gonzo says, maybe just the setup was goofed. His setup was goofed. That hill was a mess. All right. Ooh, okay, good. That's a bit of a relief. I'm glad that they seem to be working together then. Okay, well, cool. Thanks for bringing that up. If you happen to note that again, though, let me know. We'll take a look. So, yeah, the question then being, do we add this, or is this just something that's going to go for later? We'll sleep on it for now. What I want to do, though, yeah, 6.0 wish list. Yeah, I agree, which you can see is a bit of a big list. All right, let's not get too carried away here. So yeah, and actually on that note, I have here this thing that I started working on, which is basically I'm going to look at my setup and kind of figure out, you know, what do I have here that's not on the website, and should it go on the website? And so that's a me having coffee someday and a donut and, you know, figuring that out. So, okay, yeah, bringing it back down. So let's do this. We're definitely going to do this. We're going to re-add this one. And we're also going to add the patch. Because if I look here, and maybe I'm about to refute myself. Dynamic. Added 5.0, and then, you know, removed as part of 5.3 massive update fest. I don't think it's too much of a stretch to put it back in 5.4, and, you know, we're keeping it in the future. And the implementation, what I didn't get to, ooh, and I was yammering on about this, the implementation of it is completely free of sketchy edits to Beautiful Cities of Morrowind itself. And we can just see, I take a bunch, just a bunch, all these things, these activators, statics. No static, actually. And I just set them to this thing, which happens to be an invisible mesh. I don't delete them, which is what caused the problem that a user on Discord was seeing that I couldn't really see, or anybody else. But it was because specifically of the reference deleting thing. Just weird engine quirks. But yeah, it's now a much smaller patch. We're under 215 lines here. And the only deletes in this YAML format, the deletes, are the records that have a tilde on them. And yeah, we're looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6... 7 deletes. So just over a handful of deletes, and it's all stuff you can see here that comes from Morrowind. Like pieces of the vanilla ghost fence that I guess are carried over from this plugin right here. So yeah, anyway. Looking at that, we're going to add them all back. So let's figure out where this stuff all is. Mm-hmm. fixes. Yeah. I think, feel like eventually we should have a category for dynamic distance. I personally, in my copious free time, plan on implementing dynamic distance for all mods on the mod list that have statics that are adjusted. There's a lot of them. Astrologian Skilled, Building Up Averis Legacy, Averis Legacy, Rise of House Talvani, you know, like, lots of stuff does it. Most of the time you can't notice it unless you're like flying in from an angle that you would never have realistically. So I don't think all of them need work, but certainly some of them do. And I plan on making patches as I develop a workflow that's easy for doing it. I actually kind of want to have like a generator or something, so, you know, we can easily adapt it. But I want to have a category for it, you know, and maybe call it dynamic distance, you know. Adapt part of Hamaris's name here, dynamic distant buildings. But we're not just talking about buildings. It could be any static whatsoever. You know, we have, spoiler alert, turn away for 30 seconds. Rise of House Talvani plopping up in the middle of Kogaroon, you know, expanded by D-Manufacturer. You know, this is like mushrooms and growth and stuff. These are not buildings that I'm removing out of the way for this thing. Really, there are some structures like these busted buildings. There were some right here, but it's flora too, you know. So I don't like the mod was originally called Dynamic Distant Details, and I feel like that was a way better name. But yeah. So if you never played Rise of House Talvani, there's a certain point where somebody joins House Talvani and they're like, "Hey, I want to have my stronghold right by Kogaroon. Deal with it." Great mod. Oh my gosh, like amazing. One of the best quest mods out there. Improved by Mort, the 2.0, you gotta have it. But especially if you're a magic character, Talvani character, you gotta have it. So yeah, anyway though, like this is an example of a static though. When you're flying around, when you have this mod and you fly by Kogaroon, you will see this abomination. And then when you get close enough, it's gonna pop out of the view. And so the intention I have is to, you know, do what Hamaris did for the vanilla content with these so that you don't have like a jarring pop. And this one's super easy to see because Ashlands are generally flat. Not a lot of obstructions. So yeah, that's what that is. That would be really nice. Yeah. Well, I when I first saw the dynamic distant details mod, I thought, yeah, we need this. Some reason Televirith still shows up in the LOD. Yeah, so that would be because of Superstar's mod, Overhaul Legacy, building up Overhaul Legacy. Spoiler alert, fast forward like 30 seconds. But Overhaul Legacy and building up Overhaul Legacy turned the thing into like a whole city. Like with walls, Silt Strider, like boom, builds it up huge. And so that negates the vanilla changes that you find in this one. But yeah, actually, you can see it here in the banner. Without this mod, when you're walking up the river, you see this. This is like a something that is there later in the story, and then when you get close, it's gone. This mod makes it so it's just gone when you load the game. There's like a script that runs that figures out where you are, and it does the right thing at the right time. It can be potentially complicated for mods like Averis Legacy that have like a lot of things they're putting in there, or Rise of House Talvani. There's lots of different statics that are popping up at specific points, and so to kind of keep a handle on all of that will be extremely difficult. But I like to do it. And now that I wanted to do this from the beginning, but I didn't really understand how this was implemented. But it's actually good because it requires understanding how the engine works kind of at a low level. But I think I finally gotten there, and I think we can do it. Not today. Definitely not today. All right. I'm getting off the deep end here. Whoa. Wow, I really need to do that. What do you mean? I'm sorry, Gonzo. What do you mean? You need to do what? Yeah. Oh, Rise of House Havana. Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah. They're such just great mods. Like, yeah, I won't say anything more. Enjoy it. And for that matter, yeah, anything by Billy Fighter, you know, Astrologian's Guild, if you haven't done that one. I still have to do Telluris. I have a voice acting part in that mod, and I haven't even done it yet. I voice a Slowed, which, if you don't know, they're like big slug creatures. That was interesting. Gonzo says, I don't think I've gone all the way with Televirith since the Xbox days. Whoo, all right. You're in store for a treat. It's a lot of fun. A lot of good stuff there. To my knowledge, the other houses aren't really quite as well represented with like expansion, fan expansions. There's one for Redoran, I think. And there's like a Balmora-centered Halalu one, but I don't know like if they go even remotely as far as Rise of House Talvani, which is like, when I was debugging the patch that I made for the Kogruin mod, it was like, I was trying to verify that it worked, and man, it's like, this is a long mod. There's a ton of quests in there. You're not going to blow through it. I was cheating my way through it, and I couldn't blow through it. All right, here, okay. All right, and actually I never actually took this out of my personal setup, even when it was broken, just because I wanted it to be a reminder of, hey, you gotta make this work, guy. Do I have a distant details category? I sure do. All right. Let's do something here. Gonzo Game says, maybe my thief-centric alternate main quest overhaul mod that'll never be will overhaul the house Lalu or something. Yo, I mean, you know, we can make it happen in our copious free times. I have quite a bit of experience at this point, not like saying I know what I'm doing, but I, you know, I can write quests and dialogue and stuff. So hey, you let me know if you got some ideas and we can make it happen. Yeah, okay, so back to what I was trying to do. Somehow I was able to remember. I'm trying to see. There we go, yeah. This is the git log with a minus P flag that shows me the changes. You know, normally you just see like this bit right here. The commit ID, the author, the date, and the log. And maybe this information, the file that changed. But I did minus P so I could see what changed, because I wanted to see like, what did I have in there before? You just started ringing. All right. And that was by ground cover. Yeah, okay. Ground. All right. Patch is going to go right here. But we got to add it. All right. Finally get to add the mod that's intended for the list to the list. And I'm going to list, even though you download them all at once, Santa Hools, my very clever friend, says, Adventures of Hackerman stream. Hey, all right. I forgot what I was going to say now. You've distracted me. Well, I'm going to, you download all the patches together, but I'm going to list them separate. Thank you. Don't judge my horrible code. Please don't judge me. All right. Let's see. So usage notes. All right. So first off, we're going to link directly to Nexus Mods instead of my GitLab website. We're going to say this can also be downloaded from GitLab. Oh, excuse me. Okay, that's going to be the folder. I mean, is it really worth saying to use the folder if I'm going to have the folder there? I guess, yeah. Plugins in there and the folder paths and all that stuff we need for good, accurate CFG generator result. Really only needs to load after this guy. So I'm going to go ahead and actually put it in the middle there. Too many errors when I had the. I made my editor. You can see here on the right hand side here. Too many errors, because this is a really huge file, like a over almost 2,000 line YAML file. That's, whew, it's too much. Got this file name here. Adding the mod, folder path, plugin path, put it on a list, but it needs to be on quite a few more lists. Cool, already on there. Good. And I think this addition is worth a note. that it was re-added because we now have compatibility for it. What do we actually call it? Ghost fence. Usually additions don't need an explanation, I don't think, but this one, since it was added and then removed and now re-added, so I don't seem so schizophrenic. All right. Let's take a look at it. In action. And while that's crunching, let's take a look at the list. You know, it's hard to believe yesterday. You look at here, 13 out of 30 done, 43%. Sure felt like the list was a lot less checked. it feels like there's a lot more empty checkboxes, but 43% is a good number, I think. Today, about half as many things. Not quite getting as much done, I feel like. We've chatted a little bit, though. We've had some good discussion. So it's okay. But one of the things I want to do by the end of the day is we'll finish up, hopefully, maybe, review on 5.4, and we'll get that pushed out to the website and all these changes that we worked on yesterday and today. Live for everyone. This one I still gotta get to. There for sure is a level one in this mod. It's a leveling mod, if you didn't know. This guy right here. And level one is like a special case for some reason. Let's see. Since I already have it open. Let's see if we can find the offending part here. I put a note in here. There is some bug. You're ending up in a situation here where, yeah, I think I see the bug too. We're just unconditionally, when we're at level one, saying we're at level one, when really we should only say we're at level one when we go to level one, downward from level two. That's the bug right there. Maybe we'll fix it. Maybe I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure I'm not. Just looking at it now, I mean, it seems like I'm just doing it. All right. Very widely used mod, rightfully so. Link works, download page works. All right, I mean, we did it. No. See, it doesn't like it, it's too long. Deal with it. Oop. All There we go. Cool. Wow. So glad we finally have that. And I'm glad it works. And I got positive feedback from people on Discord. Thanks again, everybody. All right. Well, we've got got about 20 minutes. We can knock out a couple things that are easy, including maybe even that. I'm tempted to do that. Okay. No, this is one thing I really wanted to... That's done. I really wanted to look at. Distant seafloor usage notes. Excuse me. Sometimes I write things down, and it makes sense to me when I write them down, but right now I have... No idea. I have a vague idea of what I might have maybe thought there. So let's take a look. Ooh, Gonzo with a good one here. Thank you. I just thought of a quick test for the CFG generator. Typically, patch mods include the name of the mod before it, a la Beautiful Cities of Morun BCOM patches. Generally, these parent mods should be loaded before the child patch mods. Might take some tweaking, multiple naming conventions. Exactly. You nailed it. That's a good call out. Excellent call out. I mean, if you want to make an issue for that on GitLab, please feel free. It does regrettably depend on, like, you know, conforming to some naming conventions, but I mean, we're already doing that all over the code, you know. It's worth thinking about. Definitely not worth shooting down based on that alone. So good idea, man. Very good. And I can tell you're starting to learn how the website works because you called out the multiple naming conventions aspect, which is a chief consideration when doing something like this. So, wow, cool. Props. Looking back at this, trying to figure out what the heck was I thinking here. Or will this be one of my favorite issues that I can just solve because it doesn't need solving? Okay. Gonzo says, I'm going through the GitLab issues, and that's issue number 48 created by me. Thank you, past me. So there you go. We're going to do it. Oh, yeah, actually, I don't use the distant seafloor mod locally at all. Because I don't ever play without the shaders. Even though the water shaders are really expensive graphically. I mean, let me show you. And it's reasonable, completely reasonable, to disable the water shaders. I mean, you will get a... Well, let's take a look here, okay? No Tamriel rebuilt. You know, not a lot of extra clutter here. And we're hovering at around 30 FPS. And this is with, I think, basically everything on, but I might have the texture quality low. Yeah, because realistically... 90% of the time you're not going to notice it. Okay, so water shader off. Into the 40s. Magic. Just like that. But then you have the issue that the distant seafloor mod solves is we have like some awkward cutoff. I don't know if you can notice it. It's just above. There's an awkward cutoff of the seafloor right there. When realistically it should like just keep going, I guess. I don't know. So you only notice it when you don't have the water shader. And again, it's reasonable to want to disable it, even though it's, you know, ooh, look at that. Beautiful. It's not the most beautiful water I've ever seen, but it's certainly good. I don't ever turn it off. So anyway. Nonetheless, we got to make sure it's on there. We got to make sure that it's correct. And so I'm just sanity checking what plugins this thing comes with. let's actually. There we go. Nice little picture right there. And let's. Okay. And this is a water category item. Yeah. Okay. So I got the folder pass right, I think. Right? Yeah. Okay. Got that right. There's just some nonsense here about this old plugin. Excuse me. I have to look at this on the page. It's hard to look at the raw HTML. Okay. Alright, this one, excuse me, warrants a crunch. Distant C4, okay, boom. Yeah, oh, and this is another thing, man, I was thinking about last night that we got to do soon. Which is give the website a way to know which plugins to use with which mod list. Because right now we're going to bump into this right here. Basically, some mod lists are going to want this one. And some are going to want the Blood Moon one. Let's make sure that we're clear on where they go. You must load this before Blood Moon. Yeah, so this is a hack that's in the CFG generator. And it reminds me we're going to need to look at that code, too, for some more hideous exploration of hideous code. Put it above Blood Moon in your load order. Just load it before Blood Moon. Load it before Blood Moon. Okay, well. All right. Yeah, I mean, and it's easy to look at it right now. Gonzo says, I like how every EQ is loaded before Blood Moon. Yeah, I mean, probably was a common problem. And, you know, you can put it in here 100 times and some people still aren't going to read it and we'll still have the problem. Hemeris has went well out of their way to bug people about it. I think it says right here, the beginning of 2.0, the mod breaks Blood Moon's quest chain if you load it after. I'm just trying to figure out, do all the plugins load before Blood Moon? And I think the answer is yes. Curious if you have this one, Gonzo, and where you're loading it, but we can always, you know, we can always put it into my setup and see if it breaks some stuff. But I'm going to go ahead and just put them both up here, you know. Yeah, see, it's an ESP. Okay, yeah, we're not. Moon patch. Okay, so I actually got this squared away. Okay. They're ESPs. They load down the. Yes. Last dot in the QA. Okay, I was. Okay. Thank you for the sanity check. And then these ones are probably fine right there. Whoa, what did I just do? Don't try this at home. All right, I need to look at this now. Also worth a change log for this. Let's take a look at it. Starting to lose my voice again. I'm surprised I didn't until now. Cool. I knew there was something to that. Thank you, past me, but also write better notes. Come on. All right, well, we're creeping towards 50% with less than 10 minutes technically before the end of the program here. We can maybe bang out this one, which just requires a look at that. Yeah, I mention it. Oh, I think the issue was the person just simply didn't see it in the zip file. Okay, so I don't have to do anything on the website. Done. Love it. And we're above 50%, so that's great. Easy mode, indeed. All right, let's... All right, we already got a couple alvazir patches on here. I'm contemplating trying to, I don't want to rush it. I'm contemplating adding this one. Yeah, we should do it. We're doing it. We'll do it live. Excuse me. We're doing it live. Here we go. Sheesh, excuse me. Let's, probably wordier than it needed to be. Probably not the best commit message. Eh, whatever. Oh. Patches, yeah, okay. Alvazir, if you're out there, yo, thanks for what you do. And so this would be a yeah, okay. So let's get up here. Let's close that tab. Unique. Patch. All Been a while since I looked at this page. Okay. Yeah. Gonzo, by the way, Pelagia chat font, heck yeah. I'm doing it. As I mentioned in a prior stream, there's some do-it-yourself thing that, yeah, will let you use fonts and CSS and stuff. So, yeah, pretty sure it's possible and will be done. I just don't know when I'm going to feel like doing that. Someday, maybe. For purists. And unique items. Compilation. Grammar. And a word we don't need. Unique items. Yep. Oh my goodness. Doesn't have a folder path. Whoop. Whoa, whoa. Don't try that at home. So this would be Alvazir's page, okay. And I think just, okay. I think just Total Overhaul needs this. So, unique. And thank you. Somebody on Discord brought this up. So thank you. Distance Zero, I think. It was a nice reminder. Trying to remember what to do here. Unique items. Change log. And wow, this is going to round it out. I think we will do I'll run the test, we'll look at it locally, and then Gonzo and I are going to get together and do some GitLab review, kindly checking over my work, and we're going to merge that hopefully by the end of the day or very soon. We'll have those changes and all this stuff we've done in the past 2 days live and put a bow on 5.4. Oh my god, what did I do? No. Did I? Oh, I hit caps. Fire, yeah. Something, man. I fat fingered and it just all hell broke loose. Okay. Ooh, there's a typo right there. Look. Ooh. The test would have failed at least. Ooh, and we're forgetting. What is the... Oh, man. No. Catastrophic says, you're not still using that Razer keyboard, are you? No, that one died quite a while ago after a few runs in the dishwasher. It was a good... I got a good run out of it, I'll tell you. It was good for many years. But yeah, I'm rocking like some Logitech thing with brown switches. I think brown switches. The price was right. It was an excellent gift. Thank you. I thank you for it. Got a good price on it when you bought it. Yeah, cool. Nice. All around. All right. Okay, so adding the patch. Noting in the change log. Has a data path. Has a plugin. It's in a list. Back when Woot was rad. Aren't they like owned by GameStop or whatever now? Something depressing like that. Amazon owns them. Ooh. All right. Hey, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. All right. Well, I may honestly take a stab at this one later on. Unless Lua hacking is something people want to watch in a future stream. This one feels like it could be an easy addition, but I'm not doing it right now because I'm getting a little hangry. Losing my voice a little. But shoot, I mean, and this one too, I want to think a little bit about more exactly what verbiage to put on there, you know. But shoot, I mean, we got quite a bit done today. Some good conversation. Still need to go back through yesterday's chat for index page. Want to go through, and I got some really good feedback from War and Gonzo about, you know, possibilities for that. I want to make sure that we capture those before they get lost in VOD void. Cool, very cool. We're not going to deploy the website, but I'm checking that off just to increase our stats up there. Boom. All right, well, as soon as this finishes, I'm going to load it up and look at it, but that's about it for today and this weekend. And thank you for joining along, and thank you, big props to Gonzo for becoming the official editor, reviewer, whatever you want to call it. Thank you so much. All right, there we go. Let's take a look. Good. Yes, props to Gonzo. Yes, thank you. Thank you, it's Catastrophe. That is a good call out. Updated use instructions for modless users. Patch repairs added. Boom. Nice. And let's push that up. Push that up to GitLab. Here we go. And nice. Look at these. Excellent. Very excellent. Just now, push those changes, and we're going to keep on doing it. So I'm going to leave you at that. Have a lovely day, afternoon, evening, wherever you are. If you're watching this live with me now or later after the fact, thank you so much for being on here, and happy modding, and we'll see you next time. Peace.